SGC here, and we are back for a movie review.
My grandfather used to tell me stories all about this one soldier. As he got older, the stories got stranger. Some I believed, others I don't know.
The man who killed Hitler and then the Bigfoot. What are you, a Japanese light novel? Come on. So directed by Robert D. Kritzkowski and written by him as well. And this is his debut film. He did a short early in 2016. This stars Sam Elliott, Aidan Turner. Ron Livingston is in this. And Caitlin Fitzgerald. And that's basically everyone, really. So what's this movie about? Well, basically, it's literally what the title is, which is sort of like the thing with Japanese light novels. Google that, you'll understand. But yeah, like, it's about Sam Elliott playing an American soldier spy type of guy who goes off and kills Hitler, and then he is retired and old, and then they get him to kill Bigfoot, and that's basically the entire film. So what did I think? Well, first off, finding out that this is his debut film, I give him major props, because for him to pull off something like of this scale and just the editing and cinematography, I mean, cinematography was pretty standard, but the editing in terms of just narratively of just like going back and forth with flashbacks and just telling the story of his assassination of Hitler was pretty cool. I definitely do not know who the target audience is for this particular movie, though it did remind me of Swiss Army Man, and it's that kind of weird, far out type of thing, but that's way more weird than this. This one's very typical of a sort of just character study. Like, watching the whole thing, then I sort of understood what this movie is really about, and it's just a character study on this dude who killed Hitler and Bigfoot. At first, it's just sort of like, is it the Hitler thing or the Bigfoot thing? What's happening here? And then I think also the vibe of the movie is kind of hard to pinpoint to, because there's moments where it's actually pretty amusing, where in terms of just like the FBI showing up at his door and go like, we need you to hunt Bigfoot. And that was kind of like a situational comedy. It's just like, well, this is really weird, but it's pretty like dumb funny, because they're taking it so seriously. But at the same time, other sequences are just very like serious and just solemn. And he just thinks back about his time as a soldier and he killed Hitler. And I do like the conspiracy thing that he talks about in terms of Hitler. So that was kind of fun. But overall, it's just like interesting that Sam Elliott signed up for this. And I give him props for doing this, especially like the fight with Bigfoot. I was like, whoa, did not see that coming. And that was interesting for sure. And overall, I think this is a good character study in terms of just a man who's just like thinking about his past and just reminiscing and just thinking of just like what happened that could have happened, would have happened if it could type of thing, and just thinking about what he did and just letting go. Is it letting go, or I don't know, and just how does one live after the things that happened to his life and not having anyone recognize it or even know about it, really. So I think in terms of that kind of lens, you can really appreciate the movie. But if you just watch this straight up, you'll be like, this is such a weird film, and it's just like nothing's happening. There's no real action here. There is some struggle fight sequences, but beyond that, it's just like Sam Elliott just like doing things, and there's like a quick sort of taken sequence, but that's basically it. And I actually thought that there would be more of that, but there isn't. And it's just more of him just thinking about the past and just how he killed Hitler. And I think, well, that's in the title, and it's literally what you get. And I'm like pretty impressed that they, you know, stuck to their guns and just like delivered that type of story, and I really enjoyed it. And it's like interesting that it's not based off on anything. Like, I think this would have been so easy, not so easy, but like a typical sort of like comic narrative, but it isn't. It's just like this guy just wrote it and it exists now. So a man who killed the man who killed Hitler and then the Bigfoot. And I enjoyed it for what it is. It is what it is, in a sense, where if you go in expecting a lot, I think you'll be disappointed. At the same time, I didn't watch the trailer for this, so I didn't really know what to expect. So the majority of the movie, I'm just thinking, what is this movie really about? What's going on here? And I think it ends off really well, and it's just enjoyable in that sort of like hindsight type of deal. And I think sometimes movies are just like that. When you watch it, you're like, what's going on? I don't get this. It's confusing, weird, I don't know. Am I enjoying this? I don't know. But when you finish it, you're like, whoa, that was a pretty good execution. And I mean, granted, it has mixed and average reviews on online and stuff, but no one's really talking about it, and it doesn't really matter. I mean, it's like a cool project that Sam Elliott worked on, and it's like cool that this debut director did his debut on this and he pulled it off, and I enjoyed it, and that's all you need when you watch films, enjoyment. Anyways, so keep liking, keep watching, and subscribe. And that's it for this movie review for, what's it called again? The Man Who Killed Hitler and Then the Bigfoot. Out.